Hi there, ladies and gentlemen. What have I got for you today? Well, you can see what I've got. It is the Dynam Catalina amphibious plane. So in real life, this plane can land and take off from water and land. The last thing I'll do today, because there's no water to be found over here, and I want to first know if it actually flies before I take it out on water. Otherwise, I might have to swim on after it. So, and besides that, I want to know if it has enough power to take off. So I won't be hand launching it. Well, if it doesn't have enough power, I will be hand launching it. But yeah, I want to see if it can take off from this grass over here. So, pre-flight check, aileron right, aileron left, elevator up, elevator down, rudder right, rudder left, and throttle. Okay, wish me luck, here we go. Huh, that didn't go as expected. Yeah, this grass field is a bit rough. We'll just give it a few tries, otherwise I'll just hand launch it. It digs itself into the grass. Now this is no good. Okay, we'll hand launch it. Okay, here we go. Okay, we are in fact up and away, and I had to do quite a bit of aileron trimming. But it's up there. It's flying pretty slowly, as you can probably tell. Oh, I've got a very nice sky with those sun rays. If you hadn't figured or thought of that, this blue and yellow paint scheme makes it very easy to see in the sky. The plane is also a little underpowered, so it seems. I'm flying at 80% throttle, which I generally never do. But it's yeah, it's a bit of a lumbering giant, right? Very easy and forgiving to fly. It kind of flies like a plane with flaps fully down, and it doesn't have flaps. Okay, I'm flying with the wind now, which makes it a bit easier for the plane, of course. Maybe it would like a little more power in terms of LiPo. I have a kind of old LiPo in it. We'll try that in the next flight, if that's causing the lack of power. I'm flying it at 80% throttle, and it's, as you can tell, not blisteringly fast at all. That's okay though, this is actually pretty scale, I'd say. In real life, it's not a jet. And no stall at all. That's nice. It is very easy to fly. Yeah.
Does it have rudder?
Yes, it does have rudder. Oh, the rudder authority is very good. The aileron authority is exactly as I'd want it. Not too much and not too little. Very fluent you can fly this plane. That's nice, of course. Yeah, I've got it more or less trimmed out now. It's also quite quiet. You might not be able to hear that in the video, but It doesn't have the roar that my multiplex twin star had, for instance. Even though it's a twin engine plane. Yeah, it's incredibly easy to fly. No bad tendencies apart from the lack of power. Yeah, lack of power. Maybe it's kind of scale in its power band. In a future video I'll of course try and take it off from water. We'll see how that fares with this amount of power. Yeah, it flies very slowly, but still very controllable. No stalls at all. This works out well. Cool, and let's try and land this plane then. Shouldn't be hard at all. Oh, that was a little fast. Okay, I need a little more power so I can keep the nose from pitching down. But, well, the plane should be able to handle this rough landing. Another test was of course if it actually fits in my car. And I got it here, so it fits in my car. Reasonably successful flight. I'll use a more powerful LiPo next time. I had, like I said, a LiPo that was about 4 years old. But it flew nicely. Actually better than I had expected. Some people warned me about this plane. Yeah, in my mind, no bad tendencies. Very forgiving to fly. Thank you very much for watching, of course. And hope to see you back in another video. Bye bye.